I know it's not spooky season just yet, but I still felt like doing a bat tutorial for you guys. And even if it's not a Halloween thing, I'm sure there are plenty of bat lovers out there, me including. So what I did until now was pick my two gradient colors. And I have also lowered the opacity of both my sketch and vector layers. And now I'm just following the contour of my bat with the pen tool. One neat thing about my illustration, it's made of mostly sharp corners. They are much easier to draw with the pen tool. Here I've stopped halfway because I'm going to use a symmetry trick to make my illustration faster and more balanced. So to do that, first make sure you have closed your shape. And then just duplicate it, flip it from the Arrange tab, activate Move to Select, and Unite. Let's clean it up a tiny bit. I find that there are always a few extra nodes where the two shapes joined. And I'm also moving the gradient handle so the color is the lightest at the top of the head. Now, let's focus on these big googly eyes. I've selected a yellow gradient from my palette. All gradients and color codes will be posted down below as usual. And then with the shape tool, I'm drawing a perfect circle, which I'm duplicating for the other side. That is the base of the eye. To create the iris, I duplicate the circle again, make it smaller, and then I place it in the middle. And then I'm giving it this deep purple radial gradient. Yellow and purple oppose each other on the color wheel. So I specifically choose them to create nice contrast. Also, bear in mind that all my colors are on low opacity right now. That's why they're so dull. Here I've just created two circles and a moon sort of shape to suggest the reflections in the eye. Notice how they give our character a lot more life. And as before, I reflected everything on the other side. Let's give it a nose. I've chosen a pink to purple gradient and the pen tool to create it. Duplicate, flip, unite, boom, our shape is done. Decide to make some small adjustments here and there. And after that, I create the nostrils with the oval tool. Our bat is taking shape already. Let's move on to the mouth, where I will show you a cool technique of using brushes. To start off, I'm creating the contour of the mouth with the pen tool, as usual. But then I change the pad stroke from regular to brush mode. And here is the custom brush that I created. Watch the brush tool video if you need to brush up on your knowledge. Pun intended. The moment I make the stroke more visible, notice how it takes this cool shape, where it's wider in the middle and thinner towards the end. Next, I've made the teeth by simply tapping three times on the canvas. And then I move them under the mouth layer. The details in the ears, though, they are a bit more complex. With the pen tool again, I'm creating all the spikes here to make it look like fur. I'm really just tapping on the canvas along the sketch. As easy as that. And then I've made a few more or less parallel lines with the same brush setting I had before. It's one of those details that you don't see unless you look at the reference. But really, check out any photos of bats and you will see that they have these lines on their ears. They're supposed to help with echolocation. Cool, right? Make sure you lower the stroke bit as the lines go further and further away from the center. Small details like this make a lot of difference. I know what you're thinking. Time for some duplicate and flip action. But to avoid making my bat look boring, I'm actually going to redraw the ear shape on the other side, so it's not completely identical. Okay, I love this part. I'm bringing the opacity up on all my layers. And now everything looks as bright as it should. This sort of simple illustration can easily become a logo, for example. That's it for today. Thanks so much for watching. Let us know in the comments below if you managed to follow along, and subscribe for more tutorials like this.